I have spent a lot of time on this channel talking about various web hosting providers, but I never actually took the time to explain what is web hosting and how does it all work. So in this video, I'll answer exactly that. And if you think you know everything there is to know about web hosting, keep watching, you might just learn something new. To understand how web hosting works, you first need to understand how websites work. Every single website is composed of different files that are responsible for showing text, images, buttons, login, contact forms, and similar elements to the users. So a website, in essence, is just a collection of various files. And these files need a place where they can be stored in order to view them. And that place just happens to be a computer. Just like you would store pictures on your computer and simply open them up whenever you want to view them, the same exact way you can store website files on your computer to view your website. And at this point, you might be thinking, so wait, I can just turn my own home computer into a web server? Yes, you absolutely can. I even have a guide on how you can do that right here, but it's not the best idea. This comes with a lot of problems. For one, in order for your website to be online, your computer would need to be connected to the internet at all times. If you lose connection, that's it, your website is offline. And most home usage internet connections simply do not pack enough juice required to efficiently transfer files to thousands of visitors. You would need an extremely high bandwidth internet connection. And of course, your computer can overheat or break, or the electricity could go out, all resulting in your website being, yep, offline. As you can imagine, if absolutely everyone hosted their websites this way, we would have complete chaos. Imagine if Google, YouTube, or Facebook would be offline for days or weeks just because someone's cat spilled Coke on the computer. Luckily, people had a better solution. Web hosting companies emerged. These companies would build specialized, cost-effective computers that aren't very good for regular usage, but are extremely efficient at storing and transferring data. These computers are called servers. The next step was renting out huge warehouses to store all of those servers, making sure they're kept cool, have access to the internet and maintenance. These server warehouses are called data centers. And these bad boys are huge. The largest data center is 10 million square feet or 920,000 square meters. This is the equivalent of 170 football fields combined. And that's just one data center. There's probably thousands of them all around the world. These web hosting companies rent you the server space for a monthly fee. This way, you have a reliable and maintained environment to keep all of your website files safe and secure. But this also comes with some unique advantages. For example, they give you a control panel and an interface to manage your website easier. You also get the tools necessary to create professional-looking email addresses and configure their servers for additional security, so your websites and email addresses are safe. While all of this seems nice and great, it does come with some concerns for the future. One of the biggest ones being just how much raw electricity these mega data centers consume. Just to give you a small example, YouTube gets around 1.5 billion views every single day. To provide a smooth playback for this amount of views, the data centers storing the information consume as much electricity as 60,000 US homes do in 1 year. And that's just one website in 1 day. A big portion of the electricity consumed is then converted into heat, because the components in the server constantly increase in temperature while under load, which then requires even more electricity being used to dissipate the heat and cool the servers down. And recently, the web hosting industry has been under some heavy fire for how much electricity it consumes. Some experts even go as far as saying that as the demand increases, this will actually become a major problem. But obviously, where there's a problem, there is a solution. And some web hosting companies have already started combating this using something they call green hosting. It's basically them using solar or wind energy to power all of their servers and then planting a lot of trees at scale to offset their carbon footprint. But to summarize, this is how it all happens. Your website is just a bunch of files stored on a massive remote server that you're renting a minuscule part of while it continues to work non-stop 24/7. These servers are connected to the internet and are able to transfer the files to your viewers at a rapid speed. But another question often associated with web hosting, well, if it's all just servers in a warehouse, is every single web hosting provider equal? Not at all. Different providers have different size data centers and their servers are made up from different components. For example, some providers use the latest 2019-2020 technology, while others don't want to upgrade and still use the same servers they built back in 2005 and have been constantly working for 15 years. So when choosing your hosting provider, do some research. And now you have the knowledge about what is web hosting and how all of it works. But knowing is just half the battle. The other half is the hard part of actually going out and hosting your website. For your convenience, I'll leave my top recommended companies in the description down below, and if you buy through the links, you'll also get a discount. So, congratulations on getting that knowledge, and I'll see you in the next video.